Hi, welcome back to Scooby-u. In last week's lecture, we talked about time management and goal setting, and I gave you the assignment to read this book here. Now, you'll get a lot out of this three-lecture class series without doing the homework, but if you really wanted to change your life, you were gonna have to do the homework. Quick announcement. My office hours are Wednesday from 5 to 6 p.m. and Friday from 8 to 9 a.m. Now, I'm going to give you a homework assignment at the end of this class, and it's kind of tough, and you're probably going to need help with it. So please check out my office hours, and I'll help answer your questions to help you do your homework. So let's get on with today's lecture. This week's lecture is about setting goals. Now, in last week's lecture, I made the comment about, you know, choosing between going out, drinking with your buddies on Friday night, or cooking a batch of healthy food for next week. Now, a lot of you said, I would not give up my night with my buddies for cooking. It served its purpose. It got you riled up and it got you thinking about your goals. Without realizing it, the people out there who commented that they would not give up their night drinking, you are prioritizing your goals. You are saying, my goal of spending time with my friends is more important than it is for me to have good nutrition. That is okay. That's the beauty of this. You get to set your own goals and decide which is the most important. Before we talk about goals in general, let's talk specifically about fitness goals, because that's what most of us are interested in. If you do not have very specific long-term fitness goals, you will never achieve them. Let's take an example. So let's say your goal is, I want to get jacked. Well, why is that a horrible example for a goal? Well, it's not specific enough. Who gets to decide when you're jacked? Your girlfriend? Your buddies? What exactly is jacked mean? How do we take that and turn that into a good fitness goal to make it specific? How about this? My goal is to have a lean body mass of at least 190 pounds with a body fat of under 7%. Excellent. Specific. One thing missing though, a time. Do you want to do this by the time you're 90 or you want to do this by 2014? You need a time to make it specific. Let's look at some other excellently worded fitness goals. I want washboard abs by this summer. I want to get my black belt in karate before I turn 21. I want to be starting quarterback my senior year. I want to beat the high school track record for 100 meters. I want to qualify for the Boston Marathon in 2013. All these are examples of excellently worded fitness goals. Why? Because they're specific, they're measurable, and they have a time attached to them. Now, each of these long-term goals can be broken down into several components. We're going to cover this more in the third lecture when we come up with action plans, but let's take an example. Sometimes it's really obvious. If your goal is to get washboard abs, it's obvious you need to reduce your body fat. Other times it's not so simple. If your goal is to get the black belt in karate, you need to increase your explosive strength, increase your flexibility, increase your balance and coordination, and increase your endurance. You need all of those. Now let's talk about goals in general. The book, 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, is a great way to plan your day. The process starts by determining your roles. For example, if you're a high school student, your roles might be student, son, musician, and athlete. Those are your roles. Then for each of those roles, you come up with long-term goals. And from all those long-term goals, you break it down into daily tasks. Again, don't be overwhelmed by this. We're going to cover this in the third lecture, and it's also covered in the book. But I just wanted you to see where we're going. So we're focusing on setting goals in this lecture. For the role of musician, an excellent long-term goal would be, I want to perform a recital in Carnegie Hall by the time I'm 40. Specific, time mentioned. Another great goal for a musician might be, I want to start my own wedding band and get 4 paid gigs a month by the time I'm 21. Excellent goal. For the role of son, perhaps the long-term goal is I want to organize a surprise 25th wedding anniversary for my parents. Again, excellent long-term goal. Okay, time for your homework assignment. Number 1, decide what your roles are. The 7 Habits book can help guide you in determining what your roles are. Number 2, set at least 2 goals for each of those roles, especially the fitness. Do as many as you can, at least 1, maybe 2 or 3. The 3rd homework assignment is to go 48 hours without using the word can't. Instead of the word can't, say either I have chosen not to, I don't want to, or it is not possible to. Careful with the 3rd one. That is only for physical impossibilities. I cannot jump from here to the moon. Correct. I can't get 8 hours sleep. Ah, that's an excuse. Not a physical impossibility. Got it? 3 homework assignments. Again, remember, my office hours are this Wednesday from 5 to 6 Pacific time and Friday from 8 to 9 a.m. If you're having trouble setting your roles or your goals, we'll talk about it then. Auf Wiedersehen.